want you to see that when you are choosing your solar power, you have to keep in mind all of the items that you are going to be charging in your RV, plus leave room for the future. When I started with my solar, I didn't have as much stuff, and now I have more. Like now I have an Apple Watch, I have a GoPro that's charging, I have my phone that's charging, I have Christian's on his laptop,
yep,
I have my laptop. We have several, if we're in hot weather, we're gonna have several fans on. We have a fan running over there. I just turned this one off because I'm talking, but I had this one when I was up in my bed. I also have that one on, so I have three fans running. We also have that fan, the top fan, that is running as well because we're trying to get the hot air out. We also now have a fan in the bathroom that we didn't have, so that's also going to eat up some of our power. So when you're choosing your solar, you have to keep in mind that you are probably going to start to get comfortable and you're going to want to add more items. Now I have this large refrigerator that's really not very efficient on solar power. So in the future, I do plan on putting in some type of a Dometic refrigerator that's with a slide that slides out. It's way more efficient, you know, like a cooler style, but it is a refrigerator. And possibly two of them, one at the bottom and one at the top. One is going to be a freezer and one is going to be the refrigerator on the bottom. So those will be better for solar as well. Right now I am running this on LP gas because on cloudy days you are not going to get a lot of charging. And if you want to be able to run all of this stuff, like I got to run my fans at night. I also brought my Arctic Air, which is right there. So I can use that in the evening. If I turn on the air conditioner, I can also run my Arctic Air when I turn it off. So it'll continue to keep the area cool with no humidity. But that works off a USB. And of course, my batteries have to be charged, so I'm gonna be using that at night. Plus, Christian is in his bed, so he's gonna wanna have his fans on down here. So you have to keep that in mind. How many people are you traveling with? How many items do these people have? And it's constant. You're never going to stop charging things. But you also have to remember that if you are traveling in your car, that's a good time for you to also charge things up because you are running off your truck or your motorhome battery. So that's the opportune time for you to have things in there that you're going to be able to charge up at the same time during the day. If you have a two-hour trip, wow, you can charge a lot of things in 2 or 3 hours. So keep that in mind. Always go for more than what you think you need, because you will. As time goes on, more technology is developed and you will need more. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Hey guys, you don't only have to have an RV to have my sticker. You can also put it on your truck like I did.